After months of intense discussion, data analysis, and negotiations, NASA has reached a crucial decision. Boeing's upcoming Starliner mission will not carry astronauts. Starliner 1 will indeed be uncrewed, with a launch currently scheduled for April 2026 at the latest. However, this raises important questions. Why was this decision made? What are the strategic reasons behind this choice? How profitable is this decision for Boeing, having already suffered billions of dollars in losses? And most importantly, will taxpayers ultimately save money or pay more for fewer launches? Let's explore it all in today's episode of NR Studio. Remember that pivotal mission in June 2024? Astronauts Butch Wilmore and Suni Williams faced a significant crisis when the Starliner's thrusters failed during its approach to the International Space Station. This problem left them stranded in orbit for several months. Although the Starliner eventually docked successfully, NASA decided to play it safe. After a thorough assessment, the space agency told Boeing, "You're going to return the spacecraft, but it's coming back without a crew." To bridge the gap, SpaceX launched the Dragon mission in September 2024, carrying only two astronauts instead of the planned four, allowing Wilmore and Williams to return safely to Earth in March 2025. What was the root cause of the thruster failure? NASA and Boeing determined that it was overheating a small Teflon seal located inside the thruster valve. This seal began to fail, causing performance issues. The good news is that they not only identified the problem, but also successfully replicated the exact same failure conditions on the ground, which was crucial for developing a solution. Now, Boeing's upcoming test, Starliner 1, will focus on demonstrating the updated thruster system before astronauts return to the spacecraft. Essentially, this next mission is similar to the Starliner's USS Wheel phase, which is necessary to achieve full certification for operational crewed voyages. Although Boeing is currently transitioning to cargo-focused flights, its primary goal remains unchanged: completing certification to carry crew to the ISS. The initial commercial crew agreement signed in 2014 called for 6 operational flights after certification. However, given the various updates, the revised plan appears to be different. After Starliner 1, there will be 3 crewed flights, but only after ensuring the spacecraft's safety. Starliner 2, 3, and 4 will occur before the ISS is retired. There is technically financial support for 2 additional optional flights after that, but with the station nearing the end of its operational life, this seems unlikely. If you keep track, this means Boeing's entire Starliner flight schedule now includes 7 missions, 3 test flights, 1 uncrewed flight, Starliner 1, and 3 crewed flights after that. This contract reshuffle also impacts Boeing's launch partner, ULA. Boeing originally ordered 9 Atlas V rockets, but with the reduced number of planned missions now, some of those launches are likely to go unused.
NASA is currently holding these options, yet there are rumors they might be transferred to other clients, possibly Amazon, which has been acquiring Atlas V rockets for its Kuiper satellite initiative. Now, this is where Boeing finds itself in a difficult situation. The finances. The Starliner initiative has turned into a significant financial burden for Boeing, with losses surpassing $2 billion. Yes, that is billion with a B. The reason? The contract structure. NASA's commercial crew program utilizes a fixed price model, which entails that NASA pays a predetermined sum for each milestone, regardless of the duration or costs incurred by Boeing to achieve it. Thus, once Starliner experienced delays, redesigns, and additional testing, Boeing had to absorb those expenses. Each time they failed to meet a milestone or needed to alter a system, it was Boeing's funds at risk, not NASA's. This arrangement has been characterized internally at Boeing as entirely disastrous. The harsh truth is that Boeing has already reported multi-billion dollar losses from Starliner over multiple financial quarters. Those investments are lost. They are what in business is referred to as sunk costs. Despite the financial losses, Boeing cannot simply exit the situation. The company is still expected to adhere to its agreement with NASA unless NASA opts to alter it. Furthermore, no one is certain about the potential additional costs involved. Currently, Boeing's most sensible strategy may be to minimize future losses, or perhaps even reach break-even on the final flights. Abandoning the project now would not only result in lost funds, but would also severely harm Boeing's standing in the space industry. Thus, while Starliner may not continue beyond the ISS phase, Boeing might be considering a long-term perspective. They could still promote Starliner to upcoming private space stations, like those being developed by Axiom or Starlab, where having an alternative crew transport option in addition to SpaceX would be advantageous. From this viewpoint, maintaining Starliner makes logical sense, even if it is challenging in the short run. But this entire scenario might permanently alter Boeing's strategy regarding government contracts. After the issues with Starliner, sources indicate that Boeing's leadership has no plans to engage in fixed-price contracts again. Instead, they will probably prefer to enter into cost-plus contracts, wherein NASA or the government reimburse all incurred costs in addition to a profit margin. This marks a significant divergence between traditional aerospace and the new wave of space exploration. Established aerospace firms like Boeing and Lockheed Martin have consistently operated within the cost-plus framework, where risks are minimized but innovation progresses at a slower pace. In contrast, SpaceX has excelled in the fixed-price model, focusing on efficiency, integrated operations, and rapid iterations to keep expenses managed. This is one of the primary factors enabling SpaceX to advance swiftly, while Boeing has faced challenges in maintaining the same pace. Now, this is where it becomes intriguing.
While Boeing has been struggling with various technical difficulties and experiencing financial losses, NASA remains committed to the Starliner program. This choice is understandable from a strategic standpoint. Currently, NASA possesses only one domestically produced spacecraft capable of transporting humans into orbit, which is SpaceX's Crew Dragon. If anything were to prevent the Dragon from flying, or if SpaceX opted to concentrate solely on the Starship, NASA would be without an adequate US-based alternative for crewed flights. This scenario is not one NASA wants to encounter. Therefore, despite the financial and technical challenges faced by Starliner, NASA aims to certify it, as having two separate systems would enhance both safety and competition. Moreover, if Boeing successfully develops Starliner, it could lead to new opportunities for transporting crews to upcoming commercial space stations. Not every private entity wants to depend exclusively on SpaceX, and Starliner might serve as a viable second choice. Starliner actually possesses a distinct advantage in that it is described by engineers as launcher agnostic. Theoretically, Starliner could be launched using various rockets in the future, not just the Atlas V it currently utilizes, but potentially Vulcan or Blue Origin's New Glenn. This flexibility could prove crucial if SpaceX eventually phases out the Falcon 9 and transitions everything to the Starship. The concern is that if SpaceX stops using the Falcon 9, there might not be another rocket available that can carry the Dragon. This situation raises significant questions. Would SpaceX invest resources into redesigning the Dragon to function with another rocket like Vulcan or New Glenn? Or would they simply shift completely to the Starship, even if this results in a lack of a certified human-rated spacecraft for an extended period? It's an intriguing hypothetical scenario, which has led some individuals within the space sector to argue that NASA should prioritize certifying Starliner with Vulcan at the very least. Nevertheless, the future of Starliner remains highly unpredictable. To be frank, it has yet to achieve a single fully successful mission.
That's it for today's episode. See you next time.